does grade really matters for a fresher to get into Google or such MNCs? To apply to Google as a fresher, and do you think CP, which is nowadays kind of hype, okay, it is beneficial for cracking any kind of interview? And answered me the question that what kind of language and frameworks usually Google prefer in its company. Like, I'm not asking you to reveal its secrets, but usually what it prefers, like languages like Python or framework Django of like Flutter, Kotlin, what type of languages and framework it prefers usually?
For Google, you can learn any languages. They have a list of languages when you go for the interview whiteboard session and the first few interviews. They give you the option where you'll get a lot more languages than what you can imagine. You can answer them in any languages. But the thing is, cracking these interviews, you'll need a very strong grasp on the logic that you are using, and it should be optimized, and you won't have time to go over it during the interview. So it is very crucial to get your basics very cleared out and
of course.
One language.
Yeah.
Because these big companies will give you the privilege to select from many languages that they have an option of. So you don't have to, like, your options won't be narrowed down in these companies.
Of course, we should never miss any opportunity by giving them chance. Like, why they should not prefer us?
No. I'm telling they have option for all the languages, but you won't get an option to get them something in your terms if you're not easy enough to let them understand correctly what you're trying to say in any language, then they won't have an option to get the interview forward, because you need to be clear in whatever you are telling in any language. So they will give you all the options, but if you're not proficient in one, then you won't be able to clear out any of the interviews.
Of course, so I want to ask you that nowadays these words are kind of hyped, that AI, ML, deep learning and blockchain, these words are kind of hyped, and the numbers of students their future, like they start course in ML and something like that, but there are few students who end up by completing it. So, like, what's the scenario in big MNCs like Google? Like, what they usually prefer, and what type of intake they usually prefer? They prefer full stack developer or AI ML engineers or what? Like, I wanna know from you. Like, what's the usually scenario of those companies?
There is no preference, as in you can just apply for a normal software developer role. And you can just go in any of the projects that might also need you to have knowledge about AI and other stuff. So it totally depends on the project and the company after you clear the interview where they want to put you. So even if you go for a software test engineer job or a very low profile or low level job position, so then as well, you might get up into a more AI focused or something which is having deep machine learning and those kind of things involved in your day-to-day profile. So it totally depends on the project that the company provides you after getting onboarded. You don't have to choose anything right away while going for the interview. You can just get into these companies as easy as it can be. So if you even go as a QA something or test engineer or something like that, you can climb the ladder once you are inside these companies. It's just a matter of getting in touch with your managers and letting them know. You know, like in job placements are there, right? So these companies as well have these options. You don't need to go outside these companies and get something else. You can get into these companies pretty easily and then switch internally as well.
So guys, let me brief that and correct me if I'm wrong, Nadeem, that basically MNCs like Google, they usually hire people on the basis of their skills like DSA and operating system and like computer networking and other such things. And then later on, according to your skills, they provide you and like they provide you projects on which you are proficient. If you are having a background of machine learning, then they definitely gonna provide you machine learning project. And if you are from like you are having a background from Android development, then they of course they gonna provide you any Android dev project. Okay, am I right, Nadeem?
Yeah, because if you are directly going to apply for that, because you guys are freshers, right? So I'm guessing that you will obviously go for a job which is an entry level software engineer position.
Of course.
They will not expect you to build around everything from machine learning and these stuff right away from when you start. They'll just expect you to know a little bit about engineering concepts and those software developer skill sets, and then you how well you are getting acquainted with these companies. So they will not ask you to build up everything from scratch at first. But once you get into the job, you can try to learn more things. They have they have programs and everything, you can say, inside once you get onboarded, which can enhance your skills and might be able to give you more hands-on experiences on whatever you... I just learned yesterday from one of Google ads that they are providing courses, I think a few week courses, and then you will be proficient in...
Guys, so let me just tell you... Like Google is providing like so many courses free, and they are available on their site only, and you guys just can get enrolled in that, and you guys can have a proficient proficient background of that particular domain. So and plus the benefit of that you'll be getting a certificate from Google. So yeah, thanks Nadeem for reminding me this, and so our audience can get to know about all this. Yeah. Can you tell us what are the benefits of working in Google? Like, what are the perks? What is the work culture there? And like, what you feel to be in Google?
Feeling would be, if you are aiming for it, it will be a very good experience for you once you go to Google. The experience would be enhanced after working with the teammates, because every time you work with the Google team, they are very open to any kind of questions. They welcome juniors, and there is nothing as taking advice from someone who just joined from a person who has like 10-15 years of experience. Still, he will take your advice and look into your advices and whatever you have suggestions for them. It wouldn't be a no-no for any of the teammates. So it will make you feel a little warm, and then you'll feel it like a family. You won't feel left out anywhere where your suggestions and whatever you are telling to the seniors would be like ignored in any way. So they will welcome everything with open hands, and you won't expect a culture which you had experienced, or you might have even known looking at videos about interviews and everything. There is nothing as intimidating people over there, or some politics or anything.
And I think that's the major reason Google is the most loved IT company by everyone, like whether it's an experienced person or whether it's a
It's more
fresher.
of like SBI or some government company or government job in India where people just keep on working for years and years. So it would be pretty much a good experience. You can go bowling or play around during work hours. The only thing is that you should complete your work and get everything
In time, yeah.
in
In
time,
time,
and
yeah.
you need to focus on excellence and not go around hunting for deadlines and hunting for things to be completed on time and just get things done in a wrong way. You should get everything corrected and get things
Of
corrected in
course.
a
So,
good way.
Nadeem.
Of course.
So, Nadeem, what do you think are what are the impacts of COVID-19 crisis on MNCs?
On MNCs, mostly there is less impact, obviously, because these companies have a lot more resources than any other startup and every other company. They have backup plans and these kind of emergency plans, wherein if there is an emergency and there is something going worldwide, they can shift to different programs as well. As for Google, they had the backup plans, so they already gave an ultimatum that everything will be working and up. Like in March last year, they told that everything might be opening up and we might open things in July next year. So that was their long shot, and you can understand how accurate it was that time.
I would like to thank you and thanks a lot for joining us and
Thank you guys for having me.
So at last I want to ask you to give some small tips and advice for students who wants to be in big MNCs and you have experienced a lot from being a tier 3 college to be in a Google now. So I want you to give some advice to our audience and please give some them a guidance. Okay.
From my side, the only thing I can give is that don't just aim and go out interviewing for big companies. Look out for small companies. Work on those first. It'll give you exposure and good experience what how things work. Once you get that experience, then you can easily side by side go on interviewing for these companies. Because unless you start working, you won't get the gist of how companies work. And consider these companies as excellence companies which don't require any much in input from anyone, and there is no right path. Otherwise, everyone in India from India would be working in these companies only. So there is no fixed path.
Actually, in India, a rat race has started of getting big companies like Google and other FANG. Earlier before there was a rat race for IIT and for getting IITs, and now it became a rat race of getting into big MNCs like Google and other FANG.
There should never be a rat race because it'll end up always into a plague situation.
Disincentive
You should
yeah.
always, you should always aim for just going and living your life with whatever you are getting at the current moment, and just getting it as an experience. Because every experience will eventually end up you getting more knowledge about what and how things work. And once you have that knowledge, you can channel that easily to the interviewer at Google, because that's what they want. Stories and everything from your past experiences, how well you know things. Languages is knowing a language is easy because right now I'm speaking English, which is not our start language like back at home. Still, if you are fluent and you are working on it from past few years and you're expressing that in day-to-day life, you are easily able to channel those into your words and then make the other person more understanding, and then you are more easy to work on those things, and then yeah. you have a more control over your words, and the person in front of you is able to understand more correctly.
Like, be proficient has, in whatever you do, I guess.
More in depth, how can I put it?
Like, be proficient in whatever you do, I guess.
Not proficient, but you'll be able to channel those things easily to the person sitting in front of you if you are working on it from past couple of years, and it won't.
Yeah.
Like the thing I am going through right now. I haven't had a webinar from past couple of years, but
yeah.
since I'm going through a lot of meetings and everything all day long, it is easy for me to just get things impromptu. I don't need to prepare anything, and I can just start talking about things. I can channel things easily from my day-to-day experiences. If
yeah.
I were to not work at Google and you would have told me, just give some intro and everything about a few companies and Google, I might just had to like okay. get a homework done and
so now
done
Nadeem, like here so we are ending our session, and thanks a lot
to,
for joining us
make the,
and
the
giving our giving our audience so much of intuition
of
and so much
so
of knowledge, and today
really
we got to know
or
a very
so
large amount of knowledge, like what like what are the work culture inside Google and what kind of things we actually required while get into such big MNCs. So thanks a lot Nadeem for having us, and thank you for joining us actually. Yeah, thank you.